James Webb does it again. Another incredible discovery. Take a look at this molecule. Its name is dimethyl sulfide, but its friends call it DMS. You put it on your eyes, it burns. Do you spread it on your skin? It hurts. If you find a bottle of it, don't swallow it. Moreover, it stinks. It has a very unpleasant odor. Why would you even ever get close to it? Now it appears that our beloved James Webb Space Telescope has discovered DMS on the exoplanet K2-18b. This is an incredibly thrilling discovery, as the presence of this molecule in a planet's atmosphere could provide compelling evidence for the existence of life as we understand it. Skeptical? Keep watching the video and allow me to change your mind. We may be on the cusp of the most groundbreaking discovery ever made. Don't pass up this opportunity. K2-18b. K2-18b is an exoplanet located approximately 124 light-years away from Earth in the constellation Leo. It was discovered by the Kepler Space Telescope and confirmed as an exoplanet in 2015. Over the course of these past 8 years, this planet has never stopped amazing us. First, there was the Kepler telescope. It unveiled the presence of K2-18b orbiting around its red dwarf star. The first observation allowed astronomers to get some of the planet's key physical parameters, such as its mass, radius, and composition. As for the mass, it is estimated to be 8.6 times that of Earth. It's basically a huge planet, and this is also confirmed by its radius, which is 2.6 times that of our blue planet. This in turn makes it a super-Earth. 1 year on K2-18b only lasts 33 days. Imagine celebrating your birthday every month. This major difference is due to the fact that the planet is much closer to its star than the Earth is to the Sun. However, K2-18 being colder and smaller than the Sun, being close to it is not a problem. Everyone is safe, and you wouldn't burn had you lived on it. Of course, this is not the only exoplanet we are aware of, but for sure it is among those exoplanets that might actually be habitable. Actually, there are plenty of potentially habitable planets in the universe. Actually, it's estimated that 90% of M dwarf stars host exoplanets. These are the most abundant types of stars in the universe. They are characterized by their relatively low mass and luminosity, making them faint compared to their larger counterparts, such as G-type stars like our Sun. Despite their unassuming presence, M dwarfs have incredibly long lifetimes, with some predicted to endure for trillions of years. This extended longevity provides ample time for planetary systems to develop and evolve. Due to the lower luminosity of M dwarfs, their habitable zones are closer to the star compared to stars like the Sun. So planets like K2-18b can actually be potential hosts of life. Last but not least, when it comes to life as we know it, it is important to have a stable star. M dwarfs are the best candidates for this because they are very stable over extended periods. They're very quiet stars, and their reduced stellar activity reduces the likelihood of destructive events such as solar flares, which could strip away a planet's atmosphere or harm potential life forms. Some famous examples of exoplanets orbiting M dwarfs are Proxima Centauri b, discovered around Proxima Centauri, the closest known star to the Sun. Or maybe the TRAPPIST-1 system, which is actually home to 7 Earth-sized planets. Discovered in 2017, 3 of the planets are located within the star's habitable zone, making them intriguing candidates for further study. As you can see, it seems like K2-18b might be just another among the handful of exoplanets discovered so far. So what makes it so important? K2-18b, a Hycean planet. Take note, 2019 was K2-18b's year. That year, astronomer had the Hubble Space Telescope's mirror pointing at it, and they discovered something incredible. Further research was conducted using the Hubble Space Telescope, enabling scientists to gather more information about the atmosphere of the planet. In 2019, 2 separate studies were published based on data from the Hubble Telescope, one by researchers from the University of Montreal, and the other by researchers from University College London, UCL. Well, studies examined the spectra of starlight passing through the atmosphere of K2-18b during transits, revealing that the planet has a hydrogen-helium atmosphere with a significant amount of water vapor. The concentration of water vapor can range from 0.01% to 12.5%, and potentially even up to 50% if other gaseous elements are present. At higher concentrations, the water vapor could form clouds, and that could also mean rain. Astronomers emphasize that the presence of water in K2-18's atmosphere does not necessarily mean that the planet is habitable or capable of supporting life, as it likely lacks a solid surface or a suitable atmosphere. However, it's undeniable that the discovery of water on an exoplanet within a habitable zone provides valuable insights into planetary formation. A study conducted by astronomers from the University of Cambridge investigated the internal structure of the planet and proposed various possibilities. These range from a rocky core surrounded by a thick hydrogen envelope to a planet predominantly composed of water with a thinner atmosphere, similar to an ocean planet. Some of these potential models could potentially allow for the presence of liquid water on the planet's surface, albeit at high temperatures and pressures. In one hypothetical model, the planet consists of an iron and rock core covered by a thick oceanic layer with a thin atmosphere composed of hydrogen, helium, and water at a pressure of 130 atmospheres and a temperature of 287 Kelvin. This discovery sparked a debate regarding the nature of the water found on K2-18b. Was it in vapor or liquid form? If it was indeed liquid, this would be a groundbreaking discovery, as this planet is 8.6 times the mass of Earth and would be completely covered by an ocean. This led to the coining of the term Hycean planet. Following the modern definition, a Hycean planet is a type of planet characterized by a hot, water-covered surface and a hydrogen atmosphere. The presence of liquid water on these planets make them intriguing candidates for habitability. Biosignatures. So what do scientists look for when they want to assess whether a planet is hosting life or not? First, they make sure the planet is in the habitable region of its star. In the case of K2-18b, this holds. Then, try to understand whether the planet has liquid water on its surface, and it would be also very nice to find an atmosphere there, possibly not too thin, and as we have seen, K2-18b might satisfy both requirements. What else? Oh well, the next step is to look for molecules that are associated with life. For example, molecules like methane and CO2 on Earth are produced by living organisms. Even if you aren't producing CO2 while watching this video, methane is produced, for instance, in the digestive systems of animals. And guess what? The James Webb Space Telescope has just found both these molecules in the K2-18b atmosphere. The abundance of methane and carbon dioxide and shortage of ammonia support the hypothesis that there may be a water ocean underneath a hydrogen-rich atmosphere of this exoplanet. So there might be life there? Well, finding methane and CO2 is not enough to tell. Despite being the result of respiration and byproducts of animals and organisms on Earth, these molecules can also be produced naturally as a result of geological processes like the seepage from oil and gas reservoirs, or the natural decomposition of organic matter such as dead plants and animals by bacteria and fungi as a result of the breakdown process. But James Webb found something even better than methane and CO2, something that might actually suggest the presence of life on K2-18b. Hey, before moving on, be sure to like or dislike the video so that we can improve them for you, the viewer. Plus, don't forget to subscribe to our channel by making sure to hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our daily videos. Breaking discovery. Among the observations made by the Webb telescope is also the possible presence of dimethyl sulfide, DMS, a molecule which, at least on Earth, is produced only by biological activities. Most of the DMS present in the Earth's atmosphere comes from flatulence from marine life and phytoplankton, microscopic organisms found in the oceans. Professor Niku Madhu Sudhan of the University of Cambridge, who led the research, said he was shocked when he saw the results. So yes, scientists are excited by the potential idea of alien marine farts. different scenarios. So is everything real, or are we dreaming? For sure, the finding of DMS on K218b is not a dream. The discovery of DMS, dimethyl sulfide, provides solid observational evidence rather than mere speculation. However, it is still possible that this finding could be a result of calibration errors in the measurements. In the past, astronomers had a similar experience when they thought they had discovered signs of life on Venus. The presence of phosphine, which is associated with anaerobic ecosystems on Earth, had raised hopes of potential life on Venus, but later investigations revealed that it was an erroneous finding. Recently, the data collected by both the Atacama Large Millimeter Submillimeter Array, ALMA, and the James Clerk Maxwell Telescope, JCMT, were reviewed. It was discovered that there were background interpolation errors leading to the generation of multiple false lines, including the spectral feature of phosphine. This incident shows that even well-established scientific observations can occasionally be subject to correction and revision. There's actually another possibility. DMS on K218b might form through natural phenomena that we haven't observed yet, which don't occur on Earth. This discovery could be significant for the field of chemistry. It's hard to say for sure, but it's an exciting possibility to consider. As you can understand, the findings of DMS on this exoplanet might be significant, but it is crucial to approach such discoveries with skepticism until further confirmations are made. Continued exploration and advancements in space technology will eventually unlock the mysteries surrounding exoplanets and the possibility of extraterrestrial life. It's just a matter of time. In the meantime, remember to keep it curious. That's all for this video. Thanks for watching. Do you think we are alone in the universe or not? Let us know in the comments below. We'll see you next time on the channel.